to drive you home. Hey, the thing I think I'm most nervous and a little bit excited about talking about, we're gonna tackle in 20 minutes time.
The Rob Thomas thing?
Yeah, the Rob Thomas thing.
Yeah.
You and I are in too deep now.
We put our hands up and we said something.
I don't think you're not in too deep as well, Cackling Dad.
Well, you roped me into it. I didn't even put my hand up.
We've all said something silly, haven't we? Haven't we?
We have. And I think we've been kicking around this idea with no consequence for so long, thinking A-list stars would say no.
Full disclosure to the people of the People Show, we pitched an idea to Rob Thomas. More, I guess, is like to, in a sick way, just have a joke amongst ourselves, because we've actually thrown this idea to, I don't know, three or four different musicians that have come on the show before, because Rob's on Monday.
Yeah.
He's coming on Monday. So the normal way it works, it's like when you're in year five and your parents organise a play date. Exactly. The record label people go to the radio people, would Rob, can Rob come on the show? And we go, yeah, we'd love to have him, that sort of stuff. So then if you have an idea ahead of time, you go, ah, yeah, would he do this?
I better ask his parents.
So we threw an idea out to Rob Thomas's parents, and his parents have said, Rob would love to do that. And then we've gone, well, number one, it's now stacks of work for us, and it's also an impossible task.
Hamish and Andy. Haim, it's been kicking around for a while, and kind of a joke amongst us we didn't think would ever have to come true.
Well, we'll explain how this comes up. With a musical guest that might come to the show, let's say Bieber's coming on, right? Yeah. And we go, oh, you know, does he want to sing a song? We go, oh, he doesn't have his band with him.
Yeah.
I mean, okay, Bieber's a bad example. but, you know, someone might come on that usually sings with a band.
Yeah.
And we go, oh, and so, I don't know, a few months ago we went, someone said, oh, they can't do a song because they don't have a band with them. Yeah. They're coming out from overseas.
I think it was Adam Lambert.
Could have been Lambert. Yeah. And we went, well, what if me and Andy and Jack in here, we learnt how to play one of their songs and they could... They sing, like if we played Adam Lambert's song, yeah, Ghost Town.
Yeah.
I think we pitched it in for like, oh, we'll learn how to play Ghost Town, and then Lambert could sing. And if he doesn't like it, he doesn't have to sing. Like that's the condition is we start the musical intro, and if he just goes, I'm not feeling it, he steps out. And then
The caveat, wasn't it? It was like basically, if he doesn't think it's up to scratch when he hears the intro,
because
he sits there in front of the mic, he can bop along. But he can just not sing, and we go, okay, we weren't good enough.
And can I just say, and this might not be about Adam Lambert specifically, but this is all done with love in our hearts for the listeners of this show, because we want to give you musical treats. When we get a guest on, we want you guys to benefit from hearing the sweet, dulcet sounds of whoever that guest may be. Now, if Beyonce's coming on and she goes, look, I don't have my band, so I can't do Single Ladies, we'll do it. We will learn how to play the musical accompaniment for that song, because we want you guys to be able to hear your Beyonce's and Lambert's.
So Lambert said no. Then I think, then it became
a joke. Let's just say it to everyone.
Let's just throw it at everyone. I think Ellie Goulding said no.
Yep.
I think.
If they've been on this show, they've said no to that idea, essentially.
And so we just kept kicking along.
It was just the automatic inclusion.
Yeah.
It was like just restaurants that had $1, like just for a local charity. We just applied it to every time we talked to a record company.
And to our shock today...
I think we'd even forgot that we were saying it to everyone.
To our shock today, Rob Thomas,
yes,
frontman of Matchbox 20 and international singer in his own right,
yep,
has said yes.
Yeah, he's going to come on the show on Monday.
For Monday.
And then we went, oh, jeez.
we said to our team, what song did you pitch? And they said, Smooth. Andy, we pitched you in to play trumpet. And I was like, okay, well, I can play that a little bit.
Well, here's the thing.
Aim, you're on drums, though, I say.
We've all got our superpowers.
No,
now,
we don't.
I've owned two sets of electronic drums, so that tells you from the outset that I'm obviously very good at percussion. Andy, you played trumpet, and you're always trying to bring out your trumpet on various occasions.
I very rarely bring out the trumpet.
Jack, you're actually a good guitarist, so you're
in
probably
a band, yeah.
You're in a band.
I was in a band when I was in high school when I was 15, and we disbanded in year 10.
Yeah, but I mean, those were the days, though, right, mate? You know, you never forget. Your fingers don't forget.
The song chosen was Smooth.
Yeah.
So let's just have a listen to this. And so let's try and picture.
Can I just say right up front, one of you two goosebags needs to put up your hand and volunteer to play electric guitar. So if you think we're doing this song without the Santana part, you're an idiot. Like, it's the part.
Okay, let's have a listen.
That's me. That's one of you.
Put the trumpet in the background.
Who cares about the trumpet? Hey, newsflash, no one cares about trumpet. Okay? As an instrument, as a piece of sound, if it's a choice, if someone's going to a desert island to start a band, then you can only take one instrument. No one's taking trumpet.
I don't know. Omi, with that song Cheerleader, didn't he have a trumpet in it?
you're struggling. Don't make us try and find songs for you that have... Can we hear more of it, Jack? Like, that's not going to be it. Get some trumpet in the back.
See, no one appreciates the subtleties of just the
because
horn.
It doesn't deserve respect.
Yeah, Andy, as a more prominent member of the show, you should be playing a more prominent. Well, I'll play musical.
Drums then.
No, I'm definitely drums. 100% drums. That's the
I've
one lock we have.
I play more percussion live than you play.
And running around on stage with a triangle or a tambourine or whatever you do in your brother's band doesn't count, okay? I have sat down and professionally purchased two electronic drum kits. I've shown the most passion for drums.
Played neither of them.
And I've shown passion. I'm a lock for drums.
I think you...
I'm the summer drummer.
Okay.
It's a popular nickname, my friend.
Yeah, don't forget Xbox Rock Band.
I'm unbeatable drumming high score.
Okay. We'll keep you as drums because it's probably the easiest.
Well, you know I can only play one chord on guitar. And you can already tell from that music there's several notes. That's more than one.
It's the easiest. And I think because of your music ability lacks, you probably need to be cradled through this.
It's this kind of lack of respect that drummers throughout the history of music have had to put up with, and I am it just water off a drummer's back. It doesn't matter. Sweat off a drummer's back, sweat off my fingerless gloves.
So Jack, you're the more proficient guitarist.
How about I go home tonight and at least try to do that? But that's not the stuff I was doing in the punk band I was in.
No, because you just power chords the whole way.
And I just screamed. Wasn't one of your songs about George Bush and it had no lyrics?
one of our songs didn't have, it had a chorus but didn't have verses. Yeah. So it's just get him.
Well, we can't.
We've got Rob Thomas.
Well, we can't bring that to the table with Thomas. Just, hey Rob, if there's any part of the song that you need nonsense screamed in a punk-like way, punctuated with verses of we've got to get rid of Bush.
So, am I playing trumpet?
No.
So, what am I playing?
Rhythm guitar.
Rhythm guitar.
Oh, no, keys. Someone needs to play keyboard, don't they?
Is there keyboard in it?
I don't know. You guys are the musicians. You guys have been in bands.
There's some keys in there. There's some rhythm guitar, there's keys.
Can you play keys, Andy? Jack, you play electric guitar. I'll be the foundations with the drums.
Oh, gosh.
And remember, like, all we have to do is get that first bit right. I think if Rob sings one note...
You're the worst with time. Remember you play...
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Double time.
Then we played that game and you failed it? You got the worst out of us three keeping time.
I don't know what you're talking about. And I'm the one that spins all the tunes in here. And I've got to mix those in. Nah, great. It's settled. Rob's going to have good fun. Feeling good.
Good afternoon, everyone. Hamish Andy to drive you home. And Haim, we're pretty pumped up because... We've just come out of rehearsal.
We have. If you were listening to yesterday's show, we were talking about the fact that we got Rob Thomas. He's coming on the show on Monday, and we threw an idea out, like, kind of half-joking, saying, hey, would he sing something, and then the record label would go, no, he doesn't have his band with him. And we said, what if we learnt one of his songs, and he sung along as long as he was happy with the quality of the backing track?
Yeah.
Of us being the musicians, you, me, and Cackling Jack in here, being the musicians behind him. They came back and they said, yeah, okay, he'll sing Smooth, that song he does with Santana, if you guys can learn it. I think we might have mistakenly given the impression that we are musicians. You can play trumpet. I'm very good at Xbox drums, Rock Band Live, if you've ever played that. Jack actually can play guitar. But maybe not to the quality of a Santana and Rob Thomas.
And we
just had our first rehearsal. My God, it was fun. And I tell you what, boys, if a band can go to number one based on pure hope, we're going to number one. Hey, because we all had a crack at the song, we've decided, let's just play the song, see where we're at.
Those rehearsals will be a little later on, every shenanigans. Hey, as we mentioned, yesterday we kicked this off because it came back as a shock to us, something that we'd been joking about for a while. It went out as an original idea.
Got to remember, though, if you make jokes and the other party doesn't know you're joking, you can't be too upset with them for taking you seriously.
This first happened when Adam Lambert was coming on the show and we thought he was going to sing, and he said, no, he can't sing because his band's not here. And we said, oh, we'll be the band. Kind of as a joke, kind of as like one of what he says. And he said, no, thanks, all the same. And we all, that's funny. So then every
guests that got positioned as they can't sing because their band's not here. We kept saying, oh, we'll be the band.
And then I think maybe the perception went out amongst record labels that we're like the show hosted by musicians that has the capability to step up if needs be and be the band.
That's
not true.
We threw it again at Rob Thomas, I think a month ago.
Yep.
Frontman for Matchbox 20, and just yesterday found out that he's coming in on Monday, and yes, expecting us to be his backing band.
He's happy for us to be the backing band. So we quickly went back and said, okay, so yes, just so he knows, we're not musicians, but we will do this. We think it's funny. We'll try and be a band, but he doesn't have to sing unless he's happy. So we'll start the song. He might not have to sing one note, because if he decides to just drop the mic and walk away, we've only got ourselves to blame.
Yep. The caveat being, if we're not good enough, he doesn't have to come in.
So he has a chat with us, but he's not going to sing.
No.
And the problem is for us that we want him to sing because it's a musical gift to the listeners of this show.
We caught up today. You were on electronic drums. Yep. Jack was on guitar and I was going to be on trumpet. And we had our first rehearsal about an hour ago.
Do you want me to play what it's meant to sound like first?
I mean, this is not us, guys.
Is this not us? Who's this?
That's the original.
With Santana.
Yeah. Yeah. So that's...
I'm not mucking around. There's not a huge difference to me between what we played. We were good, guys.
We thought we'd have a crack sight unseen. This is us earlier.
Hey, band. All right. I reckon we're going to go straight into the song, see where everyone's at.
Well, I got a text from Jack last night saying that he can hold the rhythm through the song, so he put me back on trumpet. Are you fine with that?
I knew you'd bring the trumpet in anyway, so makes sense. Jack, well done.
Thank you. I'm the only one that practiced, so good to see that you guys went home and...
I've printed out the sheet music.
Mate, before we begin, I've drawn up a little chart for everyone, with a scale going from brain to heart.
Yeah.
Now, your brain instruments, your trumpets, your pianos, and your guitar requires a lot of brain.
Yeah.
Down here at the heart, drums is all heart. Exactly. I don't need to practice. Bought my heart, I've bought my skill.
He doesn't have any skill. It's a nice little jam from a man who's bringing no skill.
Let me just roll up my sleeves,
whatsoever.
Guys.
Okay.
All right, guys.
You're the intro.
We've never played before. Let's just try and do the song first up so we know where we're at skill-wise.
Okay.
Ready?
Yeah.
So
let's stop for a second.
We're stopping there, guys. Hold the take.
Now, I wasn't great.
No, you weren't. You were probably the worst.
Well, I...
Don't you reckon he was the worst, Jack?
I think we're so far away from where we need to be. It's not funny.
Are you kidding me? Everyone, go and get someone from out there at work and ask them what song that is, and they will tell you.
Let's just break it down. It's like Hamish Blake and the Time Lords here. You're just so out of time.
Well, look, you're stuck with me. You got no other chance for a drummer.
And then you do your part, Andy.
Okay. Let me just get the notes.
Well, we'll all wait then for you.
Okay.
That was pretty good.
So then
I'm fairly sure we agreed on no trumpet.
I like the trumpet. I like the
trumpet.
It adds the flair.
All right, here we go. You guys want to turn another take or we got it?
Yeah, one more. Let's try one other take.
All right, ready?
Okay.
All right, I'll lead us in again. Here we go. Santana and Rob Thomas as covered by us, the Time Lords.
Okay, start again.
You fluffed it, didn't you?
No, I didn't.
No, I think I did. Because I don't really know when to come in for your...
Well, practice more. Because I'm nailing it. Guys, this is it. He's going to love this.
We've actually got something. Hey, guys, stop again.
Sorry, I didn't hear you stopping. But you're still shuffling through your music because Jack and I don't need music and you do. Meet back here tomorrow.
We you decided to not meet back tomorrow, but continue throwing it around.
I'm proud of where we got to in three quick takes. We were starting to really gel as a band.
I'm surprised with the finger pointing that I'm listening back.
Finger pointing is one of the main parts of a creative enterprise.
From the drummer, points blame very quickly with his sticks.
Well, do you agree, Ando, that you fluffed it?
Yeah, I'm not great.
I was surprised. I thought you were a trumpet genius, and I was so surprised to see all this trumpet music you had laid out.
I've just printed the music out.
You were shuffling through it like you were a nervous grandpa at a 21st speech.
You can't play a wrong note. It's just a pre-recorded
thing. Thank you.
Anyway, we continued after this.
We've got more? We're in a musical pickle because we're trying to form a band between myself on drums, Ando. Yep. You were meant to be playing keys, but you switched to trumpet, which is your natural habitat.
Yep.
You were very, very good at high school. Jack, you're on guitar. And we're trying.
Also played at high school.
The crazy thing about this being a rehearsal was more of a tryout, wasn't it?
Yep.
Because I'm not in a band. I've never been in one. What do you do at rehearsals? Do you practice your own bits? Do you play together?
You do both.
Cool.
If something's not working, you know, we kind of distill it down a little bit more. But I think the fact that all three of us weren't really working meant it was hard to isolate where the problems were. But let's pick it up. We rehearsed for 15 minutes.
We just needed to be Rob quality.
Mm,
we want him to come in and go, you guys are tight. You're sounding great. It would be an honor to sing in front of you. Oh. This is them, isn't it? This is the real song.
Yeah, this is the real song. Yeah.
So, Jack's doing that lead stuff. Obviously, you're on drums. Yeah. And I've got the trumpet at the back. Hey, we rehearsed 15 minutes. We've just heard it, the first kind of 7 minutes of the rehearsal where we were not great, but we thought we'd have another crack at it.
I went to a high school where occasionally at the school assembly, a band would play. Mm. And at the moment, I think we're at kind of like the year five, year six level.
Yep.
I want us to get to upper school funk band level. All right? 10 and above. You're 10 and above.
Of a school that's into music or not really into
music? No. Lag behind. Very heavily sports-focused school, so hardly anyone can play music.
All right. We pick up our rehearsal a little early, Rod.
We haven't got nothing.
That's great.
But would Rob Thomas see what we've
just
done?
Would Rob Thomas come in, do you reckon, at that point?
I reckon he would.
I think we did.
Guys, let's not forget, this is our first day as a band.
Yeah.
The Beatles didn't go platinum on their first day. I think we've gone gold. We're not platinum, but we can be gold by tomorrow. Do you want to do one more just to feel the
vibe?
I'd
like to, because I'm all over the shop, and I know, because I'm just trying to read this.
Oh, sorry, I didn't know if you were ready or not.
I'm not.
I was just covering, because I accidentally missed the drums. Now, let's
rock. That much.
Sorry, I didn't know we started. Yeah.
Okay, sorry, I said let's rock. And if there's ever a cool rock song, it's Smooth. Now let's rock. I'm going to take two. I'm going to take a 2-hour.
A 2-hour?
God, you're messing with my vibe, Trump man.
Yeah, I think I need...
Donald Trumpet. You're out of the presidential race and you're almost out of the band.
Agreed. I need some work. But don't worry, I'll come back. I'll come back stronger. I can't believe that Hamish was the best.
I'm putting it on a T-shirt.
There was a lot of that, wasn't there, after the mics were turned off?
No, there wasn't. So, Haim.
Let's be honest as a band.
Okay, let's be honest.
Let's have a band meeting.
Do you want to give a bit of feedback to each other?
Sure.
Should we start with Jack?
Jack, I'm proud of you for learning some things last night. And you were playing without music too.
That was Jack feedback. You don't need to give me feedback.
I didn't give you any feedback. I gave Jack feedback. I was proud of him.
Thank you.
That you rehearsed to the level where you didn't need to play with sheet music. Because I know from my very short time in bands that sheet music can distract people.
Well, I just
I'm just giving Jack feedback.
Okay, here's my feedback for the drummer.
I'm listening.
I don't remember that much flair in the drumming. Would you agree, Jack?
Yeah, you did a lot more fills, like playing on different.
Yeah, I think that's.
And I take that on board.
You need to tone that.
I take that on board.
Down.
If I may,
you're not the front person.
If I may, tone in it my down. Defense, yeah. One of the alleged front guys was flailing around like a dead fish, looking at his sheet music. Now I'm not naming names.
I was,
and I think the band needed someone to step up.
No,
someone to come off and go. You know what? I'm normally a fast bowler, but since you guys are all out, I guess I'll try and hit some sixes.
Rob Thomas will be singing. That's why we don't need anyone stepping up, right?
We have to get to that point.
I was actually reading the music. That's why I was
getting... Well, try reading it aloud, mate, because we were bored watching you read.
Hamish and Andy.
No, good hustle, guys.
Yeah. And we haven't got to Rob Thomas.
Yeah.
The difficult thing here... is that we promised to be the backup group for him. He was travelling. He said he wasn't performing because he doesn't have his band. We said, we can play for you. Kind of as a joke, the record label has said, yeah, that'd be fine.
I think Chinese Whispers have happened and it's just got to him or got to them and they think it's serious. Anyway, long story short, on Monday he's coming in and we have, it's now in our hands, which is fun. It's a fun challenge. Mm. Can we produce up, can we get good enough at the song Smooth by Rob Thomas and Santana? Can we get it to a good enough state that Rob will agree to sing over it on Monday's show?
Sophie joins us. We asked for a music teacher a little earlier on the show. Soph, thank you very much for calling in the People Show.
Ahoy, how are we?
Ahoy to you.
Ahoy, Soph. Now, I don't know if you heard yesterday's rehearsal.
I did hear yesterday's rehearsal. It was quite humorous, I thought.
Well, our heart's in the right spot. And if we didn't say what song that was, you would know, wouldn't you?
Yeah, probably.
Pretty good.
Can you replace the word humorous with good or...
I know, yeah. It was our very first go. We were ice cold in it, man.
I'm talking about Soph's perspective.
It was
like,
a really top effort, boys.
Thank you,
really
Soph. Are you primary or secondary school for...
I teach both, actually.
Right. How often do they finish and go, how did it go, teacher? And you go, that was quite humorous.
Probably all the time.
I don't say my kids are humorous, no.
No, well, here's the thing, so I'm so excited because I've never been in a band before. Andy and Jack both have. Ando's on the horns. He's on trumpet. He needs sheet music. Jack is just playing guitar. He's learnt his off by heart. So have I. I'm on the drums.
You haven't learnt anything.
I'm playing with my heart.
You don't even know how to read sheet music.
Oh, here we go.
Anyway.
Double quaver, semi-quaver, flip top, underscore.
The reason why we've got Soph up is this is what's been happening, Soph. A bit of internal bickering when it comes to feedback.
Soph, methinks Donald Trumpet protests too much because he's covering the fact that he hasn't done any practice and he's a bit sloppy when he comes to rehearsal.
That's true. But Soph, you can listen to our latest rehearsal. We did 6 minutes before the show started today.
Giving us a total of 12 minutes for our band career.
And then we'd love your honest feedback after it.
This is our last rehearsal, really, before the day.
Yeah, well, we've only just come together for the second... Collectively, we've done 8 minutes together.
Well, I know you guys stayed behind a little bit last night in practice. Mm. Now, I felt like I wasn't invited to that rehearsal because... And I understand where you're coming from because I know I don't need to rehearse because I'm the only one that's currently on trend. Yeah. As far as the music is.
Well, you're also a little bit aggressive in feedback, and it's hard to... Yep. I don't feel confident playing...
Well, I'm going to get you for that later. During the feedback session. I'm going to get you for that dig.
Well, we're not giving the feedback this time. Remember, we're going to put it out...
Yep. Someone's going to listen to this professionally, listen to this rehearsal. Here we go. Are you guys ready?
Yep.
Here we go.
Trumpet
up?
I don't know what I'm
saying. Hey, Donald Trumpet!
What are you doing?
Okay, I went quiet for a bit there.
Yeah,
I was counting my bars rest, but then I realised I hadn't put out page 11 and I'd only pulled out page 10.
You're scattered and you're scrambling yeah. and you're snatching at excuses. No, be honest. Yeah. Be honest. Yeah. Were you just enjoying the show? Were you honestly just enjoying the show that Jack and I put on and you forgot you're in a band?
My answer was no to that. To
I think it's highly likely
that I was enjoying what you and Jack were putting down.
I think it's highly
Let's
likely,
see how
mate.
Sophie?
Your criticism was as off tune as you're trumpeting. Sophie, what did you think?
Oh, guys, do you want complete honesty?
Yeah,
that's
absolutely.
What we asked
that's
for.
What
so we're big
we'll,
boys,
we'll
we
Rob
can
Thomas,
take it.
Will Rob Thomas sing to that at least?
You just tell Andy and Jack exactly what went wrong.
Okay, well, it was a great effort by everyone who played.
Thank you.
So we got time.
I'm not quite sure if Andy would be better than my year two recorder class.
Ooh,
burn. But you could recognise the song. In my professional music teacher opinion,
small amount of
could recognise the song.
Small amount of water on the burn.
So if you're suggesting that I have the most work to do.
I would definitely say that's true.
Mm-hmm. Let's focus on some of the positives, Soph, like the drumming or whatever you think is a positive.
How about the drumming's lack of time? Do you reckon that's something we should consider?
There was drumming. That was happening.
I'll take that. Drumming was present.
And,
well, that's pretty good, Ando, because I've actually never been trained as a drummer. So for that to be drumming rather than just drum-based noise, I see as an advantage.
Definitely. That was definitely drumming. Definitely.
Drumming was present.
Thank you.
That's a pleasure.
Nice to be appreciated, Soph, because it's not happening in the band.
Thanks, Soph. Look, we can't split up. Because there's too much riding on it, but boy,
stronger and stronger.
Boy, do I want to walk out.
Oh, mate, we want to kick you out, but we're stuck with you. It's like we got a dying elephant in the band. It's horrible. It's going to be not. Ando,
really front of mind for us, is
it? No. We got a lot on our minds today, Ando.
Yeah.
A lot. And I recommend. Can
and
I just
your
say,
mind, Jack.
Jack's involved.
I've had a think about it, yes, this morning.
Can I just say, today is the day where Rob Thomas is coming in.
Yep,
and
lead singer of Matchbox 20.
We have been
15-time platinum.
If you've listened to the show for the last couple of days, last Thursday and Friday, through a long story, it became apparent to us that we will be playing. We had to learn his song Smooth with him and Santana because we said we'll play the backing track for him to sing. And if we're good enough, if our band can be tight enough, guys, he will sing over the front and we'll have had our first gig.
He joins us live and we're going to have to do a live performance at 5 PM, which is nerve-wracking because we had a final rehearsal.
Well, you know what I'm worried about? I'm worried I've done a Ronda Rousey and I was too good coming into the fight. And what if I get overconfident? That's my biggest threat.
And now, during the performance, just knock yourself
Rob
out.
Rob Thomas just kicks me in the neck.
Hamish Andy. Rob Thomas, frontman of Matchbox 20, of course, singer of this song, Smooth, with Santana.
American
joining
song.
Us in around about 50 minutes' time.
And we found out today that's the second most played song. We got handed a sheet with the stats of that song. Second most played song on radio of all time.
Wow.
So we're right up there. We're having a crack at one of the big it's a song people know. That's all I'm saying.
Rob Thomas is going to pop past. When we asked him, when we heard he's in the country, we asked him to perform. His label, the record label, said, oh, look, he doesn't have his band here. That's when, more as a joke.
We got resourceful.
We said, hey, yeah, we'll have a crack at being his backing band so he can be able to come in and sing.
We said, no band. That's not a brick wall. That's just a hurdle. Yeah. And we love hurdles.
And so they came back and said yes to our shock and dismay on Thursday. Jack, you had the most work, really, over the weekend. You were in charge of the guitar, playing like Santana.
Yes.
I don't think you have put a lot of work into...
I exploded. If you treat our Thursday rehearsal as our training camp, it's like I came to the training camp and set a world record. And everyone went, okay, what's this kid capable of? Now, granted, I've plateaued, but I've only plateaued at world record quality.
Not a plateau, really? I reckon.
Before, my nervousness is coming into this bout too good, too well prepared, and complacency is probably my biggest enemy.
We had 2 6-minute rehearsals. We just had another one about 20 minutes ago.
We do leave it late.
Are we only allowed to rehearse for 8 minutes at a time?
Because honestly, we play the song and we all look at each other and go, well, we're not getting any better. It's as good as we are.
So this
This is our last shot.
This is our last. This was 20 minutes ago.
That's it. Thomas is
Rod Hummers from the ear, who's coming past just after 5 o'clock. There is a bit of tension normally at rehearsals, and today's was no different.
Now, guys, as far as I'm concerned, we're there. So let's just do a quick tech rehearsal.
We haven't had another rehearsal. I think Jack's really done some work over a weekend.
So I stayed back on Friday.
Well done. I was busy, so I had to shoot off. But luckily, I'm there.
I had a go this morning.
Hey, trumpet man.
Yeah.
A little bit disappointed to see the sheet music's up on your microphone.
Hey, all you're doing is tapping plastic, my friend.
Very
but
well.
I did ride out the music.
Big whoops. Now, yeah. I know we all have other things to do. We've got to go and get lunch and stuff like that. So let's do a tight 5 minute tech check.
Yep.
And like,
is that a rehearsal or?
Well, we're there, so it's just a technical check for mics and things like that. Right. So, as far as I'm concerned, this is Thomas quality.
Oh, you want us to go out there playing hard?
Want us to rehearse as hard. In 30 seconds, I want to hear Thomas quality.
Yeah. Now, I just like you play.
It's fair to say that from the get-go, I've been drumming at Thomas quality, and some of us have struggled with our different instruments, even changing instruments from piano to trumpet. Now, I'm not naming names, but certainly the trumpet player has been squeaking around like a dead seal. Or at least a severely injured one.
I've got some feedback for the guitarist.
Yep.
You've done a great job.
Yeah, thanks.
You have to worry about notes as well as timing.
Yeah.
Another person in the group doesn't have to worry about notes at all.
I'm hearing a lot of barbs being thrown by the guy.
I was actually talking to the guitarist.
In the group. Well, the drummer overheard it because the drummer's got exceptional hearing, which helps his exceptional drumming.
Can you change it to exceptional timing?
Let's try keeping the squeaking to a minimum if we could, thanks Donald Trump. Here we go, guys. Thomas quality. Yep. Jeez. Come on. He's gonna love this.
They continued like this for several minutes until they were very happy with themselves.
Good. Woo! Good night!
What do you reckon, guys?
Man, he's gonna lose his shit. He'll probably be blown away by that. Yeah. He really will. I think he'll be starstruck.
I actually am gonna give some good feedback to the drummer.
And back to you, mate. I don't know if you were tricking everyone with your hooting on Friday, but you've obviously practiced.
No, I said I'm going to give some good feedback to the drummer when he deserves it.
And he does now.
It's fun. I imagine the guys that Michael Jordan used to train with. It was like, it's silly to just be patting Jordan on the back all the time and going, you're the best. So there would have been a bit of fun ribbing. And that's what we've got happening in the band too. You're ribbing your Jordan, who's occasionally going to miss a three-pointer here and there, and he probably does it to big up the team.
The Michael Jordan of electronic drumming.
Your words, mate. Jack, are you still making those T-shirts with quotes from the show?
Current Michael Jordan. I don't know. Have you seen him?
No, he's all right.
He has lost him.
He can still drive it through the key, mate. Don't
worry about that. Same Hamish Andy. Actually taken our mind out of the fact that Rob Thomas joins us in about 10 minutes.
Yeah, too much fun, mate.
We've got to get back to rehearsing.
What's our number one rule here? Serious music first, then fun if we have time. And you've put him in the wrong order.
Hamish on electric drums, Jack on guitar, myself on trumpet.
So
yeah, 10 minutes of play. Guys, game face on.
Time for a quick rehearsal?
No.
We're good. We don't need one.
When are we going to see? You know, this is for Squarespace.
Yep. I'm here to ask for an extension.
Yep.
Because I got very carried away across the weekend thinking about the Rob Thomas gig.
Yep.
And
no, you didn't practice.
Did I say practice? Jack, must we rewind the tape? Thinking, lost in thought, and to the point where my brain at some points was going so haywire with thinking about the gig, my body was flopping just lifeless on the ground.
Yeah, right.
And so my wife was bringing me food and drink as I lay on the carpet thinking about just completely motionless with my brain
a wriggle fish.
Using 99% of my body's blood, pumping through the rhythms and the drumming that I'd have to do for Rob.
So you didn't get around to it.
In those circumstances, who amongst us has time to go and update their website?
Hamish Andy driving you home. I mean, what a build-up. Rob Thomas, welcome back
to
the studio.
What's up, guys?
Nice to see you again.
Great to have you back. This is another chapter in our relationship, of course, robbing with Rob Thomas.
Yeah, yes.
Well, we were looting at a
hotel. I'm still chafed from that.
Surprised you got let back in the country. You're not on a watch list.
The new single is Hold On Forever. The album, The Great Unknown. It's available now for download, but also you just announced a tour.
Yeah, coming out in February 19th, I think, is the first show in Melbourne.
Beautiful.
Which is awesome. Rod Laver Arena and then... Yes. Around the country,
with Pete Murray.
Yeah,
I was going to say,
yeah. Including the Clips of 500, which is in Adelaide, a big race.
It's so cool coming in summer because you got the wineries, which are all kind of different.
Yeah,
and then we're doing one on the steps at the Sydney Opera House. Mm-hmm. Like, that's something I've always wanted to do. Yep. You know, so that's pretty exciting.
Because you're playing the Day on the Greens, which is the wineries. Now, do they come to you and go, "Will you play us?" Or did you hear that there's the potential to go around and just play at wineries?
Right. It sounds great.
I'm already half drunk when I do a show anyway. Yeah. So now I have less. You know, less distance that I have to go.
Cut out the middleman.
Yeah, I just go right to
it. Why don't I just play at the cellar door with a hose coming out of the barrel?
They're paying me in wine. It's just...
Rob, Now, I understand when you come back in February.
Yeah, in February. I like how you say that. You're too cool for the Rary.
It's got a lot of confusing R's. We don't trust ourselves.
We'll put all the details up at our website. I assume that you've got the backing band sorted.
Well, as of now...
Hmm. But we all know what's about to happen.
There's always a chance.
I would recommend you just lightly pencil in your backing band at the moment, but don't have an eraser too far away from your body.
Oh.
And get ready to pen us in, because today is the day.
Listen, I'm going to tell you something. This is some serious stuff, all right?
Real talk.
We're talking about the second biggest song in the damn world.
Yeah.
In the damn world.
Oh, that's why we started at the top. It's the only song
we play.
So let
me tell you something.
What's the first?
This is not... The Twist by Chubby Checker.
Oh, really?
Big stakes.
Here's what I realized, but also I want to put that in perspective. Hey Jude is number 10.
Really?
So there's actually no validity to any of this whatsoever.
Who let the dogs out is number 4. Well,
I think compared to Hey Jude, Smooth is Who Let the Dogs Out. I mean, this is, you're talking about the Beatles.
We're in rare air. If people have just tuned in, the offer we put to your people when you're coming on the show is, we said, we'd love to have you play. Mm. Then we got word back that, like, his band won't be with him. We said, foolishly, all right, what if we learnt how to play Smooth by yourself and Santana? Now, we're not the greatest musicians.
Well, you're not a musician.
Well, however, we're also not the second greatest. And we will continue down the list. I got a lot of natural percussive talent. Okay. So it made a lot of sense for me to be an electronic
drum. I can feel it. You have a certain timbre in your voice. I can feel it coming out of you.
And my voice is like a tom.
Not to mention an unbelievable sexual charisma.
That just
oozes out of you.
Classic drummer. Yeah. So immediately I'm on the drums. Andy played trumpet at high school.
Yeah. So I'm on the corns
today.
So
he's bugled.
Jack also had a band called Last Chance in high school that dismantled in... what?
When I was 15.
Yeah.
Last
Chance in high school. That's a silly name for a band.
Technically, it should be First Chance.
The way we thought it would work is, obviously, if we're not good enough, we thought you don't even have to bother coming in singing. Yeah.
All right.
Because okay,
I'll see you guys later.
So, as we start, you know, you can be assessing us.
Right.
And then, because obviously the great song Smooth starts with Santana and a bit of horns and stuff.
Right, she starts with the drums. Is this us? No, this is Rob and Santana.
Are you sure? Hold on. Can't really tell until I start singing, you know?
So you'll have this amount of time
right.
to determine whether you would like to add your voice to our band. Right.
I take this very seriously.
Yep.
I'm going to come down on you guys like a rain, like a hard, cold rain.
Yeah.
With my honesty.
Okay.
Well, I'll be coming down on the snare drum like a thunderstorm. So there'll be a lot of bad weather out there in the studio. Jack, do you want to just play? This is where we started on Thursday. This is not our current state. Bear in mind, this is where we started. This is base camp. We haven't shown you the summit yet.
Why am I scared?
This is where we started on Thursday. First crack, cold.
It sounds like Spinal Tap's Jazz Odyssey.
Good boys.
Thank God for that trumpet.
Okay.
I've heard worse.
Where?
So that's where we were. We've had three rehearsals since then.
Three rehearsals. Have about a half an hour of rehearsal refining that. We're now at what we believe to be Thomas quality.
Yeah.
We hope.
Probably I'm not sure if I'm offended or not.
That's bad. That's not Thomas quality. Yeah, that is offensive. Yeah. But we hope we're at a stage where you see the desire and the lust for greatness in our eyes and in our music, yeah, and you choose to maybe sing along with us. But you don't have to. It's in your hands.
We're going to go to a song here. We're going to head outside, back to, out to the jam room.
And, jam room.
And on the other side of this, we'll be there with Rob Thomas, and he can decide whether he wants to join us from singing smooth.
Can I ask a quick question? Do you have an issue with me if I'm take my shirt off and I wear a leather jacket?
I really have an issue if you don't. Do you, but how about a leather vest?
Mm, yeah, I can try and cut the sleeves off. It's a pretty good jacket. My wife will be angry.
We are outside in the jam section with Rob Thomas, who's stuck around. Thank you very much for sticking around, mate. Hold On Forever is your new single. The Great Unknown is available for download right now, and you're returning to the country in February. Go to robthomasmusic.com if you want to get all the details.
Get it all out now before I run out of this room.
Yeah, yeah. But I'm actually just stalling for the good of everyone.
I'm actually mentally rehearsing in my head, still thinking that if I squeeze one last one in, it's going to make a difference to our musical quality. So what, you don't want to be rehearsing when you're on stage.
If you've just tuned in, welcome, by all means. But Rob Thomas, of course, frontman, Matchbox 20, amazing solo artist in his own right. We asked him to perform when he was going to come out here, and he said he didn't have his band with him. We went back to the label and said we could play for him, and he turned out to say yes, which was a shock to the three of us.
It was the inspiration we needed to form this band, because without this gig, we probably would have never formed. So we owe our start to you,
Rob. No matter what happens, I just want you guys to know, you're very funny on the radio.
Yeah.
Okay. Nobody can take that away from you.
Are you perturbed at all that Hamish has gone tops off with a leather jacket? I mean, have you ever...
Oh, yeah, you mean, am I getting a little warm in here? Yeah.
That's right.
My jeans are tighter.
Hey, quick idea, Rob. If this works and we go touring, would you be cool if I wore like an archer's quiver and I kept my sticks in the back? Is that cool? Do any drummers do that?
Oh, my God. No. Not. But now.
You should get it happening.
But if this happens, you're going to go full leather vest.
Yes, if we're successful, I'll cut the sleeves off the jacket once we start touring.
And you all have to get Rob Thomas tattoos.
That'd
right
be
across your forehead.
After we finish our second mainland North American tour, we should get Rob Thomas tattoos on our head.
Jack's got the heavy work here. I mean, Santana is a very good guitarist.
Yes.
Regarded as one of the best.
Rob, you played with Santana.
Jack, you seem to be quiet over there.
But Rob, what's Jack like?
He was the guitar player from Last Chance, though,
Did Santana ever mention Jack?
I'm on the horns. Haim.
You're on the horns.
Good luck. The horn. Haim, good luck keeping time over there.
No worries.
The way this is going to work is we're going to come in, give it our darndest. Mm-hmm. If Rob thinks that we're good enough to be a backing band for him, he can come in at the time when the vocals come in for the song Smooth.
Yep.
This is the song we're going for. We should just play that for people.
Yeah. This is Smooth, like my Smooth, right?
Yeah, that's it.
If you do want to play Spot the Difference, there is a little bit.
There it is.
Now, I don't do any stick tapping or whatever. I just come straight in, Rob, so don't be surprised by that. Also, quite a lot of drum flair. Again, don't be spooked. Just play your natural game. We're going to have good fun out there.
All right.
You guys ready?
I'm ready.
A lot of heat coming out of here right now. Right.
We've been practicing a long time, guys. This has been coming since Thursday. Yeah. Here we go. Smooth by Rob Thomas and the Thomasettis. Playing a cover of Rob Thomas and Santana. Here we go.
And it's a hot one, like 7 inches from the midday sun. I hear you whisper and the words melt everyone. But you stay so cool.
You've never been sexier, ever.
My Mariquita, my Spanish Harlem Mona Lisa. You're my reason for reason. Step in my groove. This life ain't good enough. I'll give my world to lift you up. I'd change my life to better suit your mood. Cause you're so smooth.
Play that thing.
And it's just like the ocean under the moon. It's the same as the emotion that I get from you. Loving, I can be so smooth, yeah. Give me your heart, make it real, or it's
happen? Did you feel that? Did you feel that? Who are you?
This normally happens in rehearsal as well.
Great job, guys. We did it, guys. Yes.
Oh my god. Not normally, dude. Does it finish with a drum solo just like that?
How long did you practice for, Rob? Because you were good. You were really good.
Jacko, congratulations.
Thanks.
Great work, Josh, everybody. I think you're the most relieved. It's the first words you've said, and you're normally pretty talkative.
Great work, Hando. Man, from where you came from, too, you were saying from super low bass, you were terrible. Well done.
Rob Thomas will be back in the country, everybody, in February. Go and see him at the Day of the Green and other shows. Thanks very much for coming in, buddy.
Thanks so much, guys.
It's actually an audience.
Right, Hamish and Andy.
One, two, three, four.
Hamish and Andy, driving you home. I'm going to count us in from now on, Ando, because now we're a band. I will count us in every time we turn the microphones on.
You didn't even count us in when we did it properly at the wrong time.
But I'm evolving as a musician. Get the internet. It happens. Read about drummers.
I do have the internet. That's where people can go. HamishandAndy.com.
That's right.
The video is now up us.
Being Rob Thomas's band.
Frontman Rob Thomas, us playing smooth. Jack,
am I crazy? Is it just me, my mum, or was that great?
Your mum just called. She was very happy with us, which is very funny.
I put it on speaker for the whole band to enjoy, much like I'm sure Harry Styles did after they did their first performances one day on X Factor, and Genevieve Styles called the band to say, well done, boys. I'm very proud. You all played together very well.
Jack, the video at HamishAndy.com, you can go watch it now. I just watched it back, Jack, and I know you're pressing the buttons in here, but as far as you were so good on guitar.
Rock solid, man.
Thank you, guys.
But flair.
Oh, yeah, no.
You'll probably be standing at the back at our gigs.
You can see the concentration of my face. I'm not really grooving it out.
You don't move.
You're a workhorse, but you struggle to connect with the audience.
Jack is petrified the entire time.
I just didn't want to be the reason why that Rob Thomas turned around and goes, it's good enough, except the guy pretending to be Santana isn't, and walks out.
Well, you did really well.
Triceratops Rex wouldn't have seen you playing. You were that skilled.
Some slight finger movement, only detectable by high-quality cameras. When TV Hits comes to us and says, or whatever, like a magazine, because we want to do band posters, they might not go for you first, just because of the flair situation. Yeah. But we could jazz you up with a cool outfit.
I reckon a blonde wig, more of a seer. So you just stand there.
Something. Or just a hessian sack.
Anyway, Hamish Andy.
Just some tinsel. We get some tinsel on you. We get a bit of like attention-seeking gear on you. But
and Rob did play well, didn't you, Nian?
Yeah, Rob did all right. Well, this is the great thing. Like, we're a real band now, guys, because we've had a gig.
HamishAndy.com, the video is right there. See Jack stand still.
Yeah, you'll think it's a still. Make sure your eyes wander around the rest of the video, because you will think we've just put up a musical still.
See, Hamish, there's a point where, Hamish, you were thinking about going for a fill.
To be honest, I did Ronda Rousey it a bit. I went in, I rehearsed a lot better than I gigged, but that's why we've got to keep gigging. Am I crazy, or should we do this for at least one guest a week? Because I know we hired the electronic drum kit, we hired the guitar and stuff. Like, do we seriously think about getting a long lease on that? Who else we got coming in?
Oh, we've got Samantha Jade coming up. I think Conrad Sewell tomorrow.
Should we gig for them? Should we play for them?
We're not playing for them. We need to play with them.
We need 1 week notice. It takes me a week.
What about Conrad Sewell's actually playing himself tomorrow? Would you stop him playing normally with his own instruments so that you can play?
Yes.
We won't let him.
Anyway, it's your job to hold me back, guys, because I'm the explosive drumming force.
Straight after this, Sam.
Straight after this, Ando, I mean, I know for a fact that you were rehearsing at your house this morning.
Well, how do you know that?
Because you came in and told us. I made some calls to, there's a business nearby because I wanted to see if they heard you honking on your trumpet this morning. And good news, I threw a hook out there and I got a bite. And for people that just tuned in, 10, 15 minutes ago, we had our performance with Rob Thomas. We're all on a bit of a performance buzz at the moment. We just come off our gig, so we're riding high, and we won't sleep for days. Just from the adrenaline, sheer adrenaline of playing with Rob Thomas. Mm. He was terrific. He did his part very, very well.
Yeah.
And it was a good step for our band, because I was drums, you were trumpet, Jack was electric guitar as we played the song Smooth.
Videos at HamishAndy.com.
Check it out. I mean, as a team, I think we did exceptionally well.
Mm-hmm.
At some parts, funny. Some parts I bit off more than I can chew, and I maybe just dropped one or two beats. But other parts, I didn't bite off enough, and I regret. I regret I didn't do more during some parts.
Could swallow way too easily.
Too much air in my mouth. But anyway, you live and you learn as a drummer. And I'm certainly evolving as a musician, and I love you guys and my bandmates, and I want us to have a great career.
Thanks, man. I know. We should just go out and have a hangout without playing, because too often we're just getting together.
I know, it's taken over our lives. But also, you know, I can handle it at the moment with its six-minute bursts. I know, Andy, you came in this morning and said, I'm feeling a bit better about the trumpet part because I've been practicing at home.
Yep, this morning I had a look at it.
How annoying for your neighbours. Is there anything worse than someone practicing a loud instrument when you live in high density living? Now, I know for a fact there is a shared workspace over the back of you adjoining your apartment building. So I thought, I'm going to take a gamble here. And I called it the shared workspace, one of these places where everyone comes and works during the day, to see if anyone was around this morning and heard you honking. This is what happened.
Inspired Iron, Andrew speaking.
Hello, Andrew. How are you going? My name's Darnell Pasqualini. I live just behind you.
Okay.
Were you around this morning by any chance?
From about 8:30, 9 o'clock onwards.
Yeah, it was about 9:30. There was someone playing the trumpet.
Yes. No, that was next door to us. We could hear that.
Did you hear? It was driving me absolutely bonkers.
Yeah.
What was he doing? Or she?
I have no idea. I assume it was just working the scales and trying to improve their just general music skills, I think.
Well,
I've never heard it before, and I sit there every morning, so...
Mate, in your opinion, though, is there any improvement? That was terrible.
Oh, yeah, there's plenty of room for improvement.
I mean, I half want to know where they live just so I can go in and go, hey, mate, give up.
Well, I'm not sure if it's a, I'm not even sure if it's a, it's a new music school. Maybe I don't know if that was the case. It'd be a bit annoying. But
geez, do you think so? How
old? So I don't really know.
They'd be young, going off how old?
Yes.
That'd be 10-year-olds.
You were leading the witness.
I wasn't at all. He cornered me into saying that. I had no choice but to say 10-year-olds. And he agreed.
Look, it would have been annoying for him, no doubt. Particularly because I was trying to work out the parts. There was so much honking going on.
That's what your neighbours were thinking. And lucky for them. Now, if they're listening to this or anyone, that you can go home and tell them, hey, guys, the trumpet was a one-off occurrence. I'm going to holster it again or just play it quietly into my pillow in my bedroom like I normally do, because you do love a trumpet. 131060, though, if you've been in the situation of Andy's neighbours, I mean, when I was growing up, like as much as I love the drums now and I'm a drummer, when I was a kid, there was a drummer that lived over the back fence and just like all weekend, just the whole neighborhood had to put up with just endless drum solos.
Maybe he inspired you.
He did. And now you guys are in my position. When I was a kid, you could have put up with endless
drum solos. So what are you asking, mate?
1360, I would like, here's your chance. Lodge a noise complaint. Do you live near a noisy musician?
So if they can give out the rough area. So say if they name a street.
Yep. Name a street in a suburb. Do you have a noise complaint for someone in your area? Taylor, who is playing what in your area?
My neighbour actually plays the electric harmonica.
Do you know which neighbour it is?
Yes.
Would you like to name them?
No. Okay. Just to be safe.
What time are they playing it, Taylor?
It usually starts probably about 4 a.m.
4 a.m.?
Yeah.
Hang on, what's the electric harmonica?
Is it better or worse than the normal harmonica?
They're both just as bad as each other.
They are. One's a robot version, one's the real deal. Is it just an amplified harmonica?
I don't know, to be honest. I try and sleep through it, but it doesn't really work.
4 a.m.?
You've got a first name for us, Taylor? I mean, they may be listening, and this might be your opportunity just to...
Has anyone said anything?
Oh, yeah, we always yell out the window and out the door and...
4 a.m.? Like, what are they, live on a London radio show? I'm going to wake up at 4 a.m. and every day I do a gig for my friends in BBC 4?
Thank you, probably, Taylor. Yeah.
Probably. You're right.
From Taylor to Tyler. Who, a noise complaint, my friend?
Father-in-law.
Oh, yeah. Oh, what's he playing?
Yeah, plays the keyboard from about midnight until about 3 in the morning, out loud, every day.
Electronic
can't
keyboard?
Do it well. Yep.
So he could plug...
He has headphones. There's a headphones on.
Oh, yeah. But the sound quality is better. I think he's a musician, kind of.
It's absolutely not. The sound would be the most purest out of headphones.
Yeah, and I would know because I'm a musician. Tyler, are you living at the house?
Yes, I live at the house at the moment.
Yeah, right.
It's a pain. Just change your gigging hours, father-in-law. Like, yeah, exactly. Why midnight till 3 a.m.? It's a big session.
Oh, I don't know.
Yeah.
What's his best song?
None.
Haven't heard that one.
Yeah.
Well, it's not a glowing report.
Thank you, Tyler. Daniel, you have a noise complaint?
Yeah, I do. Yeah. It's my neighbour. He plays the drums.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah, drums are a tough one to
say. Whereabouts? Do you have the street name or his name in the suburb?
Yeah, Oxford Street and Bondi Junction.
Mm-hmm.
Bang.
And do you know his name?
John.
John, if you're out there and you live in Oxford Street, Junction.
So dense. There's like 10,000 people in that area. Yeah, no one needs to hear that all day long. Good one. Thanks, Dan. Good public service.
Put some rubber mats on your drums.
Well, do what I do and just get an electronic drum kit and wear the headphones.
Once every week.
Well, I mean, three times out of your life. Louisa, you've got a noise complaint.
I do. Lived in Napier Street in Essendon, and at about 7 or 8 o'clock every single day of the week, our above stairs older neighbour would launch into Nessun Dorma, I think that's what it's called.
Yeah.
Very, very badly.
What's Nessun Dorma?
It's an opera song.
Oh, it is an opera song.
It's, I believe, I mean, look, Casey Donovan or Anthony Kalia, one of those guys definitely would have done it.
Yep.
It's a classic.
Right.
And it has obviously the peak at the very end, which requires an extremely high note.
Is it this one? I mean, and he's got excited because I've moved back. I mean, I'm going to go for it here, Louisa. Can you tell me if I'm on the right track?
Okay.
Is it the one that goes, is it that one, Louisa?
That's it.
Almost as bad.
But Andy, I've pulled off two songs in one day that were recognisable to outside ears with no training.
Yeah, you went from coolness of being a drummer to now quoting opera.
So I dig all music.
Thomas might be, you know, he loses a bit of credit to the band, but...
one, two, three, four. Hamish and Andy driving.
It's an ad break. You can't count in an ad break.
Yes, you can. One, two, three, four. Ads.